Hello everyone, in this video tutorial I'm going to teach you how to generate different types of signals in Simulink and how to perform different mathematical operations on the same. So let's start with going to the Simulink model, and from the Simulink library under sources, let's start with the signal generator. Now, a signal generator is a block that can generate these four types of waveforms. You can select the waveform that you want to generate, adjust the amplitude and the frequency of the wave, and click on OK. Now, to observe the waveforms, you'll need a scope. So you drag and drop the scope, connect the signal generator to the scope, and simulate. That is the sawtooth wave generated by the signal generator. Suppose you have to specifically create a sine wave. You can use a sine wave function from the Simulink library. And in the sine wave function, we are given the choice to change the configuration as a time-based signal or a sample-based signal. Let's start with the sample-based signal. Now, we can adjust the samples per period. I'm going to keep it 10, and I'm going to change the sample time of the sampling and click OK. In order to observe the waveforms in the same scope, I'll change the number of axes and click on OK. Now I can observe two waves in one scope. I'll click Simulate, and that's how it looks like. That is a sample sine wave. You can also generate a train of pulses in Simulink using a pulse generator. Now, in this pulse generator, you can specify the period of the pulse and the pulse width of the pulse. I'll keep it 50% and let's change the period to 1 second. Click on OK. I'll change the axis of the signal viewer. That is a scope, and I'll click OK. Connect the pulse generator to scope and simulate. So this is the pulse train generated by the pulse generator. Suppose we have to perform mathematical operations on the signals. Let's say we have to find out the final signal of this equation. We'll get rid of this and let's start with the sine wave. Now in here we'll use a time-based signal, keep the amplitude 1 and the frequency 1. Okay. We'll need another signal wherein the amplitude will remain the same and the frequency will change to 5. Click on OK. Now, as the equation says, we have to multiply these two signals. Add to these two signals. So let's connect it to the adder block and we have to multiply it by the gain of 5. Let's connect the gain, change the value of the gain, click on OK, and then subtract 5 from the output. For that we'll need a constant block. Set the value to 5, connect, and finally to observe it on the scope. Let's see what we get. So that is the waveform generated after the finally solving the equation. I hope you enjoyed the video, and that's it for today. For further help, you can go to www.matlabhelper.com. Thank you.